Yesterday we have seen different types of the loops that we have in C, and we have also seen one example related to the for. We have seen that there exist at least main three categories of the loops, that is, one is for loop, second is while loop, and third is do while. And we have taken one example for demonstrating the for. Well, we are going to take a few more examples for for loops so that you will feel comfortable while programming with the for. So let us see, let us demonstrate the concept of whether a number is prime or not. Is it? Before going for the developing the logic and implementing the same logic, we will first do the mathematics behind the concept of checking whether a number is for a prime or not. Say for example, we have a 4 as a number, and how we are going to check whether 4 is prime or not? We say that a prime number is that particular number which is divisible by 1 and itself. Itself only. When we are talking about the prime number, and we say that a number which is divisible by 1 and itself only. I am using the keyword only. It tells me that this is actually the definition of the type of prime numbers. Let us take an example of 7. Is it? When we talk about 1, leave 7 is divisible by 1, 7 is not divisible by 2, 7 is not divisible by 3, 7 is not divisible by 4, 7 is not divisible by 5, neither is it is divisible by 6, but it is divisible by 7. That means the number 7 is divisible by 1 and it is divisible by itself. And the factors which are in between 1 and 7, they don't exactly divide. I'm talking about exact division, where remainder is equivalent to 0. Otherwise, 7 is divisible by 2 with the remainder 1, 7 is divisible by 3 with the remainder 2, 1, 7 is divisible by 4 with the remainder 3, 7 divisible by 5 with the remainder 2, divisible by 6 with the remainder 1. But I'm talking about that proper division where remainder is equivalent to 0. If it is not properly divided by the in-between factors, then we say that this number is a prime. So in order to do the same, what we need a number first. Second, we need to check whether the number is divisible by in-between factors or not. In order to demonstrate the same, let me implement the concept. We say that let us take a number num. Is it? We are talking about printf, enter the number which is to be checked. And we are going to use scanf function. Scanf, as I told you, is used for taking the input from the console or taking the input from the keyboard and store it at the address of the variable. We say that because we are using %d as a placeholder, because the reason behind using this %d is that we are going to take the integer value and place it at the address of. So we have taken the number. After that, what we are going to use, we need to check the what are the in-between factors. Let's assume we have a number is equivalent to 8. The in-between factors are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That means we need to get somehow this 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this can be achieved with the help of the loops. Let us demonstrate, because we have taken yesterday for loop. Let us demonstrate it with the help of the loop. Let's define a counter, say I. Is it? And I will start from 2 because we need to left out the number and 1. Because as per the definition, the number which is divided by 1 and which is divided by itself only those are called prime numbers. We need to check, because every number is divisible by 1 and itself, we need to check whether a number is divisible by in between factors, that is 2, so on and so on. That's why we have started from 2. So 2 less than or I less than num, tab tak chalte rahu jab tak hamare paas num ka value na aa jaye and I plus plus, aur ek bar increment karte rahu. To kya karenge hum? To hum directly to print nahi kar sakte hain, hum check karenge ki jo hamare paas ye number hai, is num percent I equivalent to 0, is it? हम एक लेंगे फैक्टर इक्वलेंट टू फैक्टर प्लस वन, ये भी एक तरीका है. तो हम ऊपर करेंगे डिफाइन फैक्टर इज इक्वलेंट टू जीरो. एट द फर्स्ट इंस्टेंस फैक्टर मेरे पास जीरो, अगर ये डिवाइड करता है तो फैक्टर को क्या करो, इंक्रीमेंट, ठीक है ना, और चलते रहो, ठीक है. ये अब क्या बन जाएगा, ये बन जाएगा 2, I बन जाएगा 2, I बन जाएगा 3, I बन जाएगा 4, so on, less than number. जब ये खत्म हो जाएगा, हम ऐसे ही चेक करेंगे. If factor is equivalent to 0, अगर फैक्टर कोई चेंज नहीं हुआ, that means वो किसी भी नंबर से डिवाइड नहीं हुआ, then what we need? Printf. The number percent d is prime number, and we are going to again display the number, that means num. If it is not the case, if it is not equivalent to zero, what is that? Then we need to define another value, printf the number percent d is not a prime number, is it? Let's first run this, and after that we are going to evaluate each and everything. Compile. Okay, let's save it as prime.c, because every C file is being depicted, is being having an extension at this is main. Okay, main has two opening braces, so let's compile it again. No errors, no warnings, and let us run this particular program. So enter the number. Say for example we are checking for 8. The number 8 is not a prime number, is it? Let me execute again. Let's check it for 7. The number 7 is a prime number. Let me check it for 5, because 5 is again 5. 5 is a prime number. Let me check it for 11. Run. 11 is a prime number. Let me check it for 13. Run. 13 is a prime number. Let me check it for now 12, because 12 is not a prime number. So 12 is not a prime. So let me demonstrate it further. So if we are going to demonstrate it, let me use the word file for that, to demonstrate the things. We say that enter the value for number, is it? Enter the value for number. Say let us assume we have taken the value as equivalent to 8, is it? Now I at the first instance is equivalent to 2, and factor is equivalent to 0. The first instance that we have seen in our program, this factor is equivalent to 0, I is equivalent to 2. After that, what we are going to do, let's make one table. In order to understand, it will be the previous value, it will be the new value of I, it will be the condition, it will be the statement, and it will increment. Is it? It will be the initial value, it will be the new value, it will be the condition, it will be the print statement or statement, and last be increment, increment or decrement. At the initial value, our I is equivalent to 2. ठीक है ना, जो new value है वो भी 2 ही है. तो num हमारे पास 8 है. Is 2 less than 8? Condition क्या है? True है. Because 2 is always less than 8. तो statement क्या है हमारे पास? जो true value, जो कल भी हमने दिखाया था, जो true value है उसके अंदर हम पूरी condition check कर रहे हैं. If num percent i, that means we are going to add here. ऐसे statement में है num percent, that means 8%, 8% 2 is equivalent to 0. क्या ये है equivalent? Because yes, because 8 is divisible by 2 and it doesn't have remainder. So ये क्या करेगा? ये बनाएगा factor equivalent to factor plus 1, that means फैक्टर पहली बार 0 था, प्लस 1, ये बनेगा 1. ठीक है, उसके बाद क्या होगा? इंक्रीमेंट होगा आई का. आई बनेगा आई प्लस 1, दैट मींस 2 प्लस 1 व्हिच इज इक्विवेलेंट टू 3. इज इट? नाउ न्यू वैल्यू ऑफ आई विल बी इक्विवेलेंट टू 3 एंड 3 विल बी अगेन चेक इट. 3 लेस देन 8, कंडीशन इज अगेन 2. That means again 8% 3 equivalent 0. 8 is not properly divisible by 3, so it's not going to add any factor, so it will increment. I will become now 4. Isi tarike se 4 less than or less than 8, condition is true. Is it? 4 less than 8, condition is true. उसके बाद इज 8% 4 इक्विवेलेंट इक्विवेलेंट 0. हम देख रहे हैं कि 8 को हम डिवाइड कर सकते हैं प्रॉपरली 4 से. यस, सो इट इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीमेंट फैक्टर. फैक्टर क्या था पहली बार? फैक्टर था हमारे पास इससे पहले 1 था, तो अब बन जाएगा 1 प्लस 1, फैक्टर विल बिकम 2. Is it? Factor will become, previous value of factor was 1 plus new value of added, it will become 2. And I will become 5. Is it? Now 5, is 5 less than 8? Condition kya hai? Again true. Again true. To ye karega, is 8% 5? Equivalent 0. It's not equivalent to 0 because 8 is not properly divisible by 5. So we are going to increment I. I will be equivalent to now 6. Again, 6 less than or equal less than 8, condition is again evaluated as true. So is 8% 6 equivalent to 0? If it is equivalent, because 8 is not properly divisible by 6, so we are not going to increment factor, we are going to increment I. So it will become, I will become 7. So 7, again, 7 less than 8, condition is again true. Again true. And, but 8%, 8 modulus operator, 7, is equivalent to 0. It is not, because 8 is not properly divisible by 7, So it will become, I will become 8. So 8, again 8 less than 8, condition is false. Is it? Because 8 is not less than 8. It is either equivalent or it is. So it will come out of the loop. Once we are out of the loop, we are checking the condition. If factor is equivalent to 0. But in this case, our factor value is equivalent to 2. So in this case, we are checking exactly is 2 equivalent to 0. Obviously, 2 is not equivalent to 0. Then condition is false, it will evaluate the else part. So what is the else part? Else part is print. This number is not a prime. So this was about the checking whether a number is prime or not. In next lecture, what we are, it will be an assignment for you people to generate a prime number, generate a series of prime numbers up to 10,000 with the help of for loop. So all are going to share their screen photos on my the group that we have created for IMCA 2020. So hope you have understand the concept of this execution of your for loop in terms to generate the value in, to generate the prime numbers or to check whether a number is prime or. Thank you. Thank you very much.